Episode 23, Annihilation. At the enclosed worker village on Sorna in the animal quarters, Jerry Harding walks past the animal cages he had been opening one by one, now looking at the second packy, opening the cage.
Go. I cannot let you die in here. Go, be free.
The only animals left now are the three young velociraptors, two greyish and one brown, growling and hissing at him. Looking at these cages, Jerry hesitates.
Now, what do I do with you? Can I let you go too?
Outside he hears the sound of the helicopters leaving.
I guess I'm done for anyway.
He opens the cages and while he stays kneeled, he looks down at the ground, expecting the worst. Still looking down, he speaks to the raptors.
Go. You're free.
Hissing, growling and uncertain, the three young raptors move sideways in their cage, approaching the exit with distrust. Low to the ground, they come out of the cage, growling at Gerald. Jerry moves, crouching even more into himself, pressing his chest against his knees. But nothing happens. The young raptors ran for the door. As they quickly run past Sarah Harding, who is now just standing outside the door of the entrance, she jumps aside. Hissing as they go, Sarah looks after them, surprised and a little scared for a moment. Then she steps inside.
Dad? Dad, are you alright?
She moves for her father, helping him getting to his feet.
Sarah, you're back. What are you doing here? You should be on that helicopter.
I know, but I couldn't let you stay out there alone now, could I?
If I'd have known you were here, I...
That's not important now.
Then, Tim, who also came after Sarah, comes walking in too. Is he okay? Because I think he lost his mind, letting those raptors out.
I'm okay.
Now what do we do?
I think we should try to contact Hoskins. He must still be out there too.
I think there's a radio in Henry's office.
They move through the soundproofed compartment to Henry Wu's research office. The hard drive and the sample still lying on the desk. Sarah moves for the radio behind the desk and tries to reach Hoskins.
Hoskins, come in.
Nothing. Another frequency.
Hoskins, this is Sarah Harding.
We have to move for the cliffs. Maybe we could signal them somehow.
We should take this.
And Jerry takes the disc and the cure of Henry Wu's desk, putting them in his inner jacket pocket. Sarah switches frequencies again.
Hoskins, come in. Over.
In the jungles on Sorna, Hoskins clicks off his radio again. He's sitting crouched down, surrounded by green ferns and a thorn bush. He turns his attention to something out there. Raptors. Hoskins whispers.
What do you want? Why not kill them?
He's looking at four people, surrounded by raptors.
What's that?
From his viewpoint, he sees the woman's back, and through her arms, he sees that the man behind her pushes two eggs forward towards her.
Eggs?
A male raptor coughs, having spotted the eggs.
Is that what you're after? Eggs?
He sees the alpha female commanding the other raptors in the pack. When a helicopter passes overhead, Hoskins looks up, but sees nothing. The raptors communicate to each other and Hoskins sees them picking up the eggs.
Animals this far can be trained. Imagine that. Trained killers.
Then the raptors run off. One passes by Hoskins very close, sees him and hisses. Hoskins closes his eyes and looks down, but the raptor moves on, following the alpha female and the rest of the pack. Slowly Hoskins opens his eyes and sighs relieved. He looks back at the location where the family was sitting. They moved away.
Horse crap, where'd they go?
Then in the distance, he hears a voice shouting.
Beach.
A short moment later, as the helicopters depart from the beach, Hoskins comes out of the jungle line. He sees two helicopters flying in the direction of an aircraft carrier out on the ocean, and one flying directly in the direction of the mainland. The beach is full of soldiers, securing the area. Now headed back to the landing crafts, one of them, looking back, spots Hoskins.
There's another one. What happened? Why are you not with your friends?
Hoskins approaches the soldier, who's trying to guide Hoskins away from the jungle.
Not my friends. Tell me, where's that helicopter going?
Straight to Costa Rica. Lawyer got them out. To be quarantined and questioned there. You can come with us, sir. We need to be off. Any others behind you, or are you the last?
I'm alone.
Good. Come on.
The helicopter's carrying Henry Wu, the commander, and the control workers, is landing on deck, while a heavily armed carrier strike group of six jets is preparing for takeoff, more bombs per jet. As soon as the helicopter lands, the doors are opened and Henry Wu jumps out, trying to run to the preparing jets. but he is held back by the USAF soldier coming after him, shouting over the noise of the Jetson helicopter.
I cannot let you through, sir. Please follow them. They'll guide you to your quarters.
Henry Wu has to shout back.
You can't do this. You can't bomb the island. I need something that's out there.
That's not up to us, sir. Go with them. You can't be here.
Desperately, Henry Wu walks back to the officer, now coming out of the helicopter.
I need to speak with your commander, please.
All right, hold on.
The officer pushes a button on a radio near his shoulder and speaks into it. Henry Wu cannot hear what he's saying through all the other sounds on the ship. It's like an industry area. The officer lets go of his radio and looks up.
Okay, he's agreed to hear you.
The officer looks at the two soldiers from the helicopter, guiding the commander and the three control workers together with Ryan and Raymond.
Take them to the mess hall, we'll meet you there.
Then he turns back to Henry Wu.
Come on, come with me.
The officer leads Henry Wu into the superstructure, leading up a few stairs to the bridge. While climbing the stairs, Henry Wu hears the engines of the jets firing up, almost ready.
Come on, come on.
They arrive at bridge level, and the officer opens the door. They enter onto the bridge. Through the windows of the bridge, Henry Wu sees the planes outside almost ready for takeoff. People leaving the platform. Over the radio, the helicopter pilot taking the Kirby family back to Costa Rica sounds panicking.
They're flying right past us.
Call them off. Abort the mission.
The captain of the ship looks back annoyed.
You heard that? Your flying reptiles are leaving the island. What the hell are you guys pulling? Didn't I tell you there would be no delay?
Through the window, Henry Wu sees the first plane take off, quickly followed by the others one by one.
You really want the extinction of these creatures credited to humanity?
The captain laughs at this.
For all I care, they died from the disease they carry. I'm just saving humanity from the same fate.
The cure is out there on the island.
Then I'm sorry. I told you to take it with you. I must assume you're trying to trick me, and there is no cure.
They didn't let me take it. Trust me, lives depend on it. If you bomb the island, you destroy all data, and a cure can never be created in time if those pteranodons start an outbreak. I'm telling you, you're making a mistake. The disease is more deadly now than it ever was. We need that cure.
The captain remains silent for a moment, thinking. Then he picks up a horn.
This is the captain of Carl Vinson. I need to speak with the president immediately.
We don't have time. Abort the mission.
Strike leader, approaching target.
As the captain explains the situation over the phone, Henry Wu brings his hands up to his head, digging his fingers into his hair. And while the captain listens to the president,
Strike leader, dropping bombs.
No!
On the island, Sarah, Tim and Jerry are standing outside the wall, looking up at the jets passing overhead. Four dots coming down.
They're dropping the bombs. Move!
They run into the jungle and the ground shakes when behind them the bombs hit the village, blasting away the wall in their direction. Balls of fire reaching for the sky. Sarah stops, having reached the end of the jungle, looking down at the river below. Tim almost runs into her, with Jerry only just behind.
No! Jump! Go!
A fourth bomb hits right behind them, blasting Sarah and Tim off the cliff. Sarah falling backward, trying to turn further back into the air to make a smooth dive head first. Tim falling forward, swaying his legs to gain a straight position, feet first, both going deep underwater.